everyone, welcome to today's class of engineering physics. Today we are going to learn about forced oscillation. So already I have explained what is simple harmonic motion, what is damped harmonic motion, and now we will study forced oscillation. So as discussed earlier, in the case of simple harmonic motion, if no resistance acts on the body, then the body oscillates for indefinite time. In the case of damped oscillation, we have learned that if some resistive force acts on a body, that resistive force can be the frictional force or the viscosity. The body, after certain oscillation, it comes exponentially to rest. Now, if you have to continue the oscillation of the body, means if the body has to continue its oscillation, some external periodic force has to be applied. So we all know, in the case of swing, if we have to make it oscillate for a continuous interval of time, what the person has to apply a force to overcome the resistive force what it is acting on the body. So the definition says that the oscillation of the body under the action of the applied periodic force is known as forced oscillation. So what it happens, first if we say the body does not oscillate, so firstly what it is, the frequency of the external periodic force is not quietly same as that of natural frequency of the body. What it happens, initially the body oscillates with its natural frequency, but after some initial erratic movement, it oscillates with the frequency of the applied force. And due to this external periodic force, the body continues to oscillate with the frequency of its. So initially the body oscillates with the its natural frequency, and after some erratic movement it takes the frequency of the applied force and continues to oscillate. So we have some example, oscillation of a swing, which I have discussed now, which is pushed periodically by a person so that it continues to oscillate. The vibration of a eardrum caused by the sound of surrounding medium, you can take example of tuning fork, and the motion of a hammer in a calling bell. So these are examples of the forced oscillation, where the body oscillates under the action of the applied periodic force. So now let us discuss the differential equation and the solution of the forced oscillation. So to derive the differential equation of forced oscillation and its solution, we'll proceed as we have proceed same as the simple harmonic motion or the damped harmonic motion what we took. Here what it is, that is, in the case of simple harmonic motion, any force was not acting to oppose the motion of the body. In the case of damping, we have a resistive force which is acting on the body, which ultimately stops it. And in the case of forced oscillation, we have to apply the external periodic force. So to derive the differential equation, we'll consider a body of mass m executing oscillation in a damping medium, acted upon by external periodic force. The body is oscillating in the damping medium and we have to apply the force to keep it oscillating. So what are the forces which is acting on the body? So first it is the restoring force. As usual, what we took in the case of simple harmonic motion, whose magnitude is minus ky, where k is spring constant, and the negative sign suggests that the restoring force and the displacements are in opposite direction. Now the second force, because the body is in the damping medium, a resistive force proportional to the velocity but in the direction opposite to the displacement acts on the body, and we have already understood that it is given by minus r divided by dt. Minus sign suggests that the displacement and the resistive force is also the displacement and the resistive force are in opposite direction. And the third force which is acting on the body is the external periodic force, the force which has certain frequency. So the external periodic force, and we are representing it by F sin pt. As it is an external periodic force, so we took a sine function, and F represents the maximum value of the force, and here p is the angular frequency of the external periodic force, and this external periodic force we call it as driving force as well. So let us write the equation as usual. So the total force acting on the body it is minus ky minus r dy by dt plus f sin pt. Negative, as these two forces are in the direction opposite to the displacement, and the external periodic force what you are applying, it is in the direction of the displacement of the body. And what we know, the body's motion due to resultant force obeys the Newton's law. So we can write the body's motion due to the resultant force obeys Newton's law, and as per the Newton's law, what we know that the resultant force can be given by mass into acceleration, which is m d2y by dt square, and we can equate to this total force which is acting on the body. So we get m d2y by dt square is equal to minus ky r dy by dt plus f sin pt. Let us write it as equation number 1. So for the convenience of understanding, in the case of simple harmonic motion, we didn't had these two term, minus r dy by dt plus f sin pt. So while solving the equation, we have considered m d2y by dt square is equal to minus ky, means under the action of only the restoring force, the equation will be m d2y by dt square minus ky. And when we took the damping condition, we have we have introduced an additional term, that is minus dr minus r dy by dt, which tries to stop the body from oscillating and ultimately it comes to rest. And now we are adding a force, that is F sin pt, which with the help of this force, external periodic force, the body will be under oscillation. Body will be under the continuous oscillation. So we have now the equation in the case of forced oscillation, m d2y by dt square minus ky minus r dy by dt due to damping, and plus f sin pt, that is the external periodic force. Now let us solve using the previous procedure itself. So let us divide equation one by m. We get d2y by dt square. When you divide by m, m will be cancelled out. You get d2y by dt square. The minus k by m into y, then minus r by m dy by dt plus f by m sine of pt. Now let us bring this two term to the left hand side. We get d2y by dt square, bringing minus k by m into y to the left, it is plus k by m into y, bringing minus r by m into dy by dt to the left, we have plus r by m dy by dt, and that is equal to f by m into sin pt. So d2y by dt square plus k by m into y plus r by m into dy by dt, that is equal to f by m sin pt. Now we will replace this k by m, r by m and f by m by a constant. d2y by dt square. Let us write the term first, r by m dy by dt, and r by m will replace it by 2b as usual, what we have done in damped oscillation condition. So 2b dy by dt plus k by m will replace it by omega square y, and that f by m we are replacing it by f sin pt. So here 2b is equal to r by m, and b we call it as damping coefficient omega square is equal to k by m, and f is equal to f by m. Let us write it as equation number 2, and this equation number 2 we call it as differential equation for the forced oscillation. So equation 2 represents the equation for sorry represents the differential equation for the forced oxidation. So the question may arise that derive the differential equation for the forced oxidation and hence find the amplitude of oxidation, or derive the differential equation of forced oxidation, find the solution for the forced oxidation, that is you have to derive the displacement equation for the forced oxidation, that is the y value. So let us try to solve equation 2, the differential equation for forced oxidation, and for that we will consider a general solution. So the general equation, when the body oscillates with the frequency of the applied force, in that case we can write it y is equal to a sin pt minus alpha, where a and alpha are the constants, it is arbitrary constants, and we have to find the value of the same. A is amplitude of the oscillation and alpha is the initial phase. So now we know what is the value of y, that is a sin pt minus alpha, where p is the angular frequency of the external periodic force or the driving force. So now what we have to find the value of dy by dt. So we'll differentiate once this equation 3 with respect to time, and then again we'll differentiate with respect to time to get the value of d2y by dt square. So differentiating equation 3 with respect to t, we get dy by dt a sin pt minus alpha, it will be cos pt minus alpha, and with respect to t you are differentiating, so p will be multiplied with, so we will get ap cos of pt minus alpha. Differentiating again, means differentiating equation 4 with respect to t, we get d2y by dt square, and that will be equal to a. Differentiating pt minus alpha with respect to t, we get p, and p multiplied by p, it is p square, and cos pt minus alpha differentiation, it will be minus sine of pt minus alpha. So we have now value of y, dy by dt and d2y by dt square. So we will substitute this value in equation 2. So substituting equation 3, 4 and 5 in equation 2, we get minus AP square sine of PT minus alpha plus 2b dy by dt is ap cos pt minus alpha, then omega square plus omega square. Y value is a sine pt minus alpha, and that will be equal to f sine of pt. Now let us write it as equation number 6, and also we can take sine pt minus alpha common. Further we will expand equation. Now further we will expand the right hand side of the equation so that we can equate with the left hand side. So we can further simplify equation 6 and can write sine pt minus alpha common is minus ap square, and here it is a omega square, and then 2b ap cos pt minus alpha. Expanding the right side of the equation means f sine pt, we can write it as f sine of pt minus alpha plus alpha. We have subtracted pt with alpha and again added alpha. If you minus alpha plus alpha, it will be cancelled out, and you can retain the same term f sine pt. Now this equation, now this term sine pt minus alpha plus alpha is in the form of sine a plus b. Sine a plus b, and formula we know, sine a plus b is equal to sine a into cos b plus cos a into sine b. So here a is pt minus alpha and b is alpha. So further simplifying this equation, we can write sine of pt minus alpha, here a is common, so a omega square minus p square, then copy as it is the term, 2b ap cos of pt minus alpha, and this can be written equal to f sine a means sine pt minus alpha into cos of alpha plus f this f cos of f cos of pt minus alpha into sine alpha. Let us write it with as equation 7. So if we equate the coefficients of sine pt minus alpha and cos pt minus alpha of the left hand side and the right hand side, what we get, The coefficients of sin pt minus alpha in RHS and LHS, that will be equal. So we can write A omega square minus p square is equal to F cos alpha. And equating cos pt minus alpha, we get 2BAP is equal to F sin alpha, or AP is equal to F sin alpha. Let us assign it with equation 8 and 9. Now, what we have to find the value of first A. A is the amplitude of forced oscillation. So, let us first find the value of A. So, to find the value of A, let us first, so to derive the value of A, let us first square and add equation 8 and 9. So we have to square and add left hand side to the left hand side and right side to the right side. So, we get A square omega square minus p square whole square plus 2BAP square, that will be equal to F square sin square alpha plus F square cos square alpha. If you add it, square and add it, we get F square cos square alpha plus F square sin square alpha, which we have rewritten it as F square sin square alpha plus F square cos square alpha. Now, here what we see that A square and A square is common. So, we will take it out and write A square minus omega square p square whole square plus 2 square is 4 b square. A square we have already took it as common. 4 square b square p square will get. F square we take it as common. So, we get sin square alpha plus cos square alpha, and this value it will be equal to 1, because we know sin square alpha plus cos square alpha, it is equal to 1. So, further simplifying, we get A square is equal to F square sin square alpha plus cos square alpha, it is equal to 1, and take this omega square minus p square whole square plus 4 b square p square to the denominator of the right hand side of the equation, we get omega square minus p square whole square plus 4 b square p square. So, finally, if you take square root of the equation both the side, you get A is equal to f square square root, it will be equal to f, and that is divide by square root of omega square minus p square whole square plus 4 square d square p square. So this equation, let us assign by equation 10. So equation 10 is the expression for amplitude in the case of forced oscillation. So we have started with general solution. We have differentiated, substituted, equated the equation and simplified to get A is equal to F divided by square root of omega square minus P square whole square plus 4 B square P square is the equation for the amplitude for the forced oscillation. So the displacement equation for the forced oscillation we can write as, so you remember we took the general solution for the differential equation for the forced oscillation, y is equal to a sin pt minus alpha, that was equation number 3. So from equation 3 and 10 we can write, so from equation 3 and 10 we get y is equal to, substitute the value of A, that is F divided by square root of omega square minus P square whole square 4 B square P square sine of PT minus alpha. So let us assign with equation number 11. So this equation 11 is the expression for displacement, or we can say it is the solution for differential equation for the forced oscillation. Now given the amplitude of the oscillation, which is f divided by square root of omega square minus p square plus 4 b square p square, depending on the value of omega and p, means the natural angular frequency of the oscillation and angular frequency of the applied force, the three cases arise. When omega square is greater than p square, when omega square is equal to p square, and when omega square is less than p square, what will be the amplitude and the phase, means alpha value in the case of forced oscillation, let us discuss. So we have already derived the value of amplitude and displacement equation for the forced oscillation. Let us also derive the equation for the phase of the forced oscillation, that is the value of alpha. So we know equation 8 is given by A omega square minus P square F cos of alpha, and equation 9 has already derived, it is 2B AP F sine of alpha. Now let us divide equation 9 by 8. What we get is 2BAP divided by A omega square minus P square is equal to sine of alpha divided by F cos of alpha. So this, so here AA cancels out, we get 2BP divided by omega square minus P square is equal to, your FF cancels out, sin alpha by cos alpha, it is equal to tan alpha. So therefore alpha, it will be equal to tan inverse of 2BP divided by omega square minus P square. So based on the value of omega and P, that is the natural frequency of oscillation and the frequency of the driving force, three cases arise. Let us discuss those three cases. The value of P and omega, means P less than omega, P is equal to omega, and P greater than omega, that is if frequency of driving force is less compared to the natural frequency of the oscillation. This is the case when the frequency of driving force is equal to the natural frequency, and here the frequency of the driving force is greater than natural frequency. So to discuss these three cases, let us start with the amplitude and the phase relation for the forced oscillation. And we know that amplitude equation is given by F by M 1 divided by square root of omega square minus P square whole square plus 4B square P square. Let us assign with equation A, and alpha is equal to tan inverse of 2BP divided by omega square minus P square. So let us first start with case 1. Case 1, when P is less than omega, that is the angular frequency of the driving force is less than the natural frequency, means the natural angular frequency of the body. So if we take P much less than omega, if we simplify the amplitude value, here we can neglect the P square value as P is very small, and if we consider that P is negligibly small compared to, means if P is negligible, then this 4B square P square, which we can write it as 2BP, that will be nearly equal to 0. So if P is much less than omega, then omega square minus P square whole square will be nearly equal to omega to the power 4, and 4B square P square will be nearly equal to 0. So if we take these two conditions, we get A is equal to F by M 1 divided by omega square, and this is equal to F by M. We know omega square is equal to K by M, so F by M into m divided by k, as omega square is equal to k by m. So this is equal to f by k. Now coming to the value of alpha, if 2bp, 4b square p square is nearly equal to 0, and if you take square root of 4b square p square, you will get 2bp. So if 2bp is nearly equal to 0, then we will get alpha is equal to tan inverse of 0. So this suggests that alpha is equal to 0, because tan 0 is 0. Now based on these two derived values, we can say that amplitude depends on magnitude of force that is f value, and second, it depends on force constant that is k. And the phase relation alpha is equal to 0 suggests that the applied force means the applied periodic force and the displacement are in phase. The amplitude depends on the magnitude of force, also on the force constant, and alpha is equal to 0 suggests that the applied periodic force and the displacement are in phase. Now let us discuss the case 2 when p is equal to omega. When p is equal to omega, in this case, when p is equal to omega or omega is equal to p, this term becomes 0. So we get amplitude is equal to A is equal to f by m, 1 divided by square root of 4 b square p square, as this term is 0. So amplitude will be equal to f by m 1 by 2bp. If we derive the value of alpha, omega square minus p square, omega and p are equal. So this value will be equal to 0, and anything divided by 0 gives infinity. So alpha will be equal to tan inverse of infinity, which suggests that alpha is equal to pi by 2. Now as we took p is equal to omega, so we can also write this equation as a is equal to f by m 1 by 2b omega. So it doesn't matter if you write 1 by 2bp or 1 by 2b omega, as p and omega both are equal. So based on equation c, what we can say that amplitude of the forced oscillation, it is large, A is large if B is small. Means if the damping is small, the amplitude of the forced oscillation, it will be large, and vice versa. That is, if A is small, it suggests that B is large, means the medium is, the body is under the action of highly resistive force. And the alpha value is equal to pi by 2. Alpha value pi by 2 suggests that the applied force that is periodic itself, the applied force and the displacement are out of phase. So the case 3, when P is much greater than omega, the value of P is larger compared to omega. So we can neglect the omega square value here and solve for the amplitude. A equals F by M 1 divided by square root of minus P square whole square plus 4b square p square. Now if we consider that damping is small, means it is negligible, then we can neglect the term 4b square p square here and we get A is equal to F by M 1 divided by square root of minus p square whole square, you will get p square. And if we solve for the value of alpha, here omega square minus p square, omega square is negligible compared to p square. So we get alpha is equal to tan inverse of minus 2b by p. Here omega square minus p square, as omega square is negligible, you will get 2bp divided by minus p square and pp cancels out. So you will get alpha is equal to tan inverse of minus 2b divided by p. So if the damping is small, means nearly equal to 0, alpha it will be equal to tan inverse of minus 0, which suggests that alpha is equal to pi. So we see from equation of the amplitude, amplitude depends on the force, amplitude depends on the applied force and the frequency of the driving force. So in this case, amplitude depends on the applied force and the frequency of the applied or the driving force. The applied force and driving force is the same meaning. Now, taking alpha is equal to pi, we understand that displacement and the applied force has phase difference of pi. So, we can say that in case 1, the applied force and the displacement are in phase. When p is equal to omega, then the displacement and the applied force has phase difference of pi by 2. and when in the case 3 the difference is pi. So in this class we have learned the definition of forced oscillation. We have derived the differential equation of forced oscillation, and using this differential equation of forced oscillation we have derived the amplitude and the phase for the forced oscillation, and we have derived the equation of displacement for the forced oscillation as well. And then we have discussed the cases of amplitude and alpha based on the value of p and omega, that is the frequency of the driving force and the natural frequency of the oscillation of a system or a body. Thank you.